Hello, everyone, and welcome to Machine Minutes with Grobe. Having a properly calibrated machine directly affects the part quality your machine is capable of achieving. Grobe has developed a volumetric compensation system to ensure the highest accuracy throughout the entire work area. Today we will show you how to implement this system on your Grobe machine. Our volumetric compensation system is made up of four individual cycles. Grobe perpendicularity calibration determines and activates the compensation values of the three linear axes to one another. Squareness check confirms the quality of the GPC compensation. Grobe swivel axis calibration determines and activates the compensation of the rotary axes. Five axis check confirms the quality of the GSC compensation. In order to run these cycles, you will need the kinematic measuring set containing two calibration spheres, as well as a touch probe loaded into the tool magazine. Before we begin, we need to make sure our VCS status is set to one. On the HMI, first press the menu select soft key. Select the HMI soft key at the bottom right. Next, select the diagnosis soft key. Then press the compensation soft key, followed by the VCS soft key. Here you can see the current VCS status. If the bubble is green, then VCS is active. If the bubble is gray, then VCS is inactive. Press the VCS level subtraction soft key on the right. You will then need to enter the password. To find the password, refer to your production supervisor or contact Grobe Service. Press the VCS level subtraction soft key until the VCS status indicator is set to level 1. To be sure that VCS is on level 1, press the overview soft key on the left. To generate the cycles, be sure the machine is in jog mode by selecting the jog hard key on the HMI panel. Press the Grobe soft key at the bottom of the screen. Next, select the GSC soft key on the right. Now press the guided geo calibration soft key at the top right of the screen. In this screen, we can choose multiple options for the cycles. The hide stops option should be set to no. This will allow the machine to display instruction messages during the cycle. Setting the warm-up option to yes will run the warm-up cycle to ensure the machine temperature is in a stable condition for calibration. Since our machine is already warmed up, we will select no. Be sure yes is selected for GPC, squareness check, GSC, and five axis check. Triori for the GPC cycle should be set to yes. The number of A and B positions should be both set to 5. Triori for GSC should be set to yes. Be sure all the settings are correct and then press the OK soft key on the bottom right to generate the cycle. Now that the cycle has been generated, press cycle start. The machine will position itself and display a message giving directions on where to place the calibration sphere. Make sure the sphere is clean prior to running the cycle. Threading the calibration sphere within 2 millimeters away from the probe. Also be sure it is centered in the X and Y direction. Close and lock the door, then press cycle start. The machine will position itself again, followed by another display message giving directions for placement of the second calibration sphere. Again, make sure the sphere is 2 millimeters away from the probe and centered. Also make sure the sphere is clean. Press cycle start, and now it will check the delay time of the probe. After the probe delay time is set, the GPC cycle will start, followed automatically by the squareness check cycle. As the spheres are getting probed, data is gathered, which is then written to an algorithm. After those cycles are ran, another message will appear asking for the removal of the calibration sphere. Remove the sphere in front of the probe, then close and lock the door and press cycle start. The probe will then check to be sure the calibration sphere was removed. Once the probe confirms only one calibration sphere is inside the machine, it will then run GSC and then 5-axis check. This algorithm will now calculate the compensation values, which will now be used in the machining process. After all the cycles have ran and the calibration is complete, we will then check the results. To view the results, press the Program Manager soft key at the bottom of the screen. Inside the NC drive, open the Workpiece folder. Scroll down and open up the Grobe Cycles folder. Further down, you will find the G_GSC_Utilities folder. Now locate the ME protocol file and open it. Refer to your documentation or contact our service department if you have questions. After the cycles have been ran and the compensation values are reviewed, we are ready to cut parts. Join us in our upcoming video to learn more about your Grobe Machining Center. Until then, stay productive, keep cutting, and we'll catch you next time.